So alter table command, this one is very simple command. This allows you to change the definition of the table. Let's say you want to add a new column. Let's take in the orders table, we see that order number column was defined as 4 characters. And finally, you have reached the maximum number of order ID, that is 9999. Now you want to add more characters, because after 9999, the next value will be of 5 digits, right? In this case, you will have to modify this column so that you can increase the column width from 4 to 5, or maybe 10, because you don't want to change it frequently. So you can increase it to a good number, right? So you want to add a new column, you want to modify an existing column, you want to rename a column, you want to drop a column. In such situations, the alter table command will come into picture. So guys, these commands I'll just walk you through. I want you to practice in your lab, because these are very simple commands, and once you try it, it will be easy for you. So alter table, give the table name and define the action you want to do, whether you want to add a new column, modify an existing column, rename a column, or drop a column. So if you want to add a column, give the column name and the data type. You have to define the data type whenever you're working with the columns. When you want to modify the column, let's take the quantity column. Above, we define the width as 5. Now I want to modify it to 7. So give everything same, but with new values, new width. Let's take you want to rename a column. So rename the column name, the old value to the new value. Very simple commands. And alter table orders, drop column quantity. So guys, these commands, create, alter, drop, rename, truncate, and comment, these are auto commit commands. Even if you do not specify commit, they will be automatically committed inside the database. So be very careful when working with these commands. Next is making a table read only. In real time, what happens is, before you even drop a table, what you do is, or let's take before you drop the entire database, you try to make it read only so that people can read the database still for some time. And then you will see if really people are not reading from the database for like 60 days, then you can drop the database. That's the general practice. The same goes with tables. Let's take someone says, hey, let's drop the products table, or let's drop the orders table. Now, these are critical tables inside the database, and it's not a good practice to right away go ahead and delete the tables. What you do is you make those tables read only. You watch if really no one is reading or querying from the tables for at least like 30 days or 45 days. Then it's a good idea to drop the tables. Because the application team guys, they are sometimes stupid. What they do is they'll tell you, hey, drop the table. Now, if you go ahead and drop the table, again, after 1 week, they'll say, hey, you know what? We want the table back. We have other requirement. So in such cases, what you do is make the table read only so that people can query the table, but they cannot make any changes inside the table. Sometimes like history tables, transactional tables, like on 1st Jan, you want to make previous year data or previous year table read only, which has all the transactions of 2018. Like on 1st Jan 2019, what you can do is you can make the 2018 transactional table as read only, because you want to make sure no one changes or modifies the data, but they are able to read. Right? So how do you make a table read only? Alter table orders read only. Simple command. So mark column as unused. So guys, I am giving you an assignment over here. Once you mark a table as read only, how do you mark it back as read write? Even if you know the answer, don't tell it now, but make a note of this in your notes. This is your assignment. I want you to get answers to it. All right. If a table is marked as read only, how do you change it back to normal table? Mark column as unused. So guys, whenever you want to drop a table, drop a database, or even drop a column, we just saw the command, right? Alter table orders, drop column. It's always a good idea to wait for some time. Don't right away delete things inside database. This is one of the biggest learnings you can have from this entire session. Whenever you work with data, do not right away throw the data away because it will backfire you. The same goes with table. As I mentioned, if someone asks you to drop the table, don't drop it, make it read only. The same goes with column. If someone asks you to drop the column, try to make it unused column for some time. All right. So this command will make your column unused. That means that column will not be used in your queries. And later on, if applications team says that, hey, you know what, we don't need the column any which ways, or you see that no one querying the column, you can delete all the unused column with this one command. So it's always a good idea to wait and hold for some time before you drop a table, drop a column, or drop the entire database. So that's alter table commands, guys. So one assignment for you.